Capturing photos often produce color casting due to lighting, leading to some major color issues and affecting the whole image. Color casts exist because one or more color channels is inappropriately strong or weak, resulting in discoloration of an image. Shooting in RAW mode is recommended because when you convert your image, you can employ any white balance setting. This particular picture was captured with white balance set to auto, which means the camera decided what the correct white balance is for the scene it sees, so you may not have consistent color. And in this picture, we do have some color cast. So in this tutorial, I will show you how to color balance a photo by normalizing the RGB values, remove color clipping, and adjust tones. Now, inside the library module and the image we will be working on, the next step is to jump into the develop module. And you can access the develop module from right here if you just click where it says develop, or you can press the letter D on your keyboard, like so. Before we begin color correcting and adjusting our image, a couple of things I would like to mention. First, we're going to use the histogram to evaluate the colors and corrections. You can access the histogram right here, so just click on it, and now you can see the whole spectrum of the RGB. Then, below that, we're going to use the tonal controls, which are under the basic set of tools, to adjust our image. Now, looking at this image, and then looking at the gray histogram, which pretty much covers the whole spectrum, this means the image is very well balanced because we don't have huge offsets of the RGB. What we do have, though, is on the whites here, we have a blue color cast. And you can see also in the image, we do have an overall blue color cast. The second thing I would like to mention is that we need to have the clipping indicators turned on. You can access the clipping indicators right here under the histogram. You can just right-click or command-click on the Mac. And first, make sure that you have the show clipping indicators on. Then after that, you would need to have the clippings on. Basically, you can right-click or command-click or press the letter J on your keyboard. And when you do that, we have show clipping on. These indicators basically help us to adjust critical highlights and shadow values without losing detail. You see, when I zoom in here, I have loss of detail on probably the whites. So clipping is when you have loss of detail either in the brightest area of the image or the darkest area of the image. It matters because the image will not print very well because there is just not any detail there. It's pure 100% black or 100% white. When a color begins to clip, it means it goes to its maximum value. Another thing we're going to do is we're going to create a virtual copy of our image, which is a copy of an image file created virtually. A virtual copy is a metadata in the catalog that stores the different sets of adjustments, thus saving us a lot of disk space. This way, you can have multiple versions of photos by applying different adjustment settings, post-process them differently, and compare them or export both. To create a virtual copy of an image, right-click on the preview image down in the film strip, right here. So I'm going to right-click, or actually you can go to the photo menu and then create a virtual copy. I myself prefer to just right-click and create a virtual copy. As you can see here, we have two images, but basically we have the original one and then the virtual copy. So once we do that, this is the master photo that displays the number of images. You see one out of two. And where the virtual copy, this one, displays the page turn icon on the left side of the thumbnail, right here. So So let's go ahead and use the histogram to evaluate colors and corrections. Now, reading the histogram from the far right, we start with the whites, followed by the highlights, midtones, shadows, and blacks. Our first step is to color correct the image. Remove the blue color cast we can see on the histogram right here, and then work on the tonal controls and not vice versa. Removing the color cast first sets all the tonal values so we don't end up going back and forth between two corrections. And we're going to do this numerically and neutralize the RGB values to be equal or close to equal. So in this image, we are looking for neutrals, something that should be a neutral color, and then balance that. In this case, the men's sweater right here, this around this area, should be a neutral color with close to equal, close or equal RGB values. Okay, so the way we're going to do this is going to use the white balance selector tool. You can just click on it or press W on your keyboard. And then we're going to select the temperature, so select that field here. Then we're going to move the white balance selector tool around the area here on the top of the men's sweater and try to find a neutral color. As you can see, there are a lot of neutral colors I can probably pick on. Then what we're going to do is we're going to use the up or down arrow keys on your keyboard and try to bring those RGB values as close as we can. You see this little pop-up window says pick a target neutral, and below that we have the RGB values. So I'm just going to move the cursor somewhere, let's say around here, and right now it reads 88.7, 90.8, 94.5. So I'm going to tap the up arrow key on my keyboard, and at the same time looking at the histogram on the whites on the far right, as you can see, the blue color cast is almost being removed. And looking at the RGB values here, I have 91.5, 92.2, 91.2. That's great. That's as close as we can get. So now I'm going to press escape a couple of times. As you can see again on the histogram, we move the blue color cast. And if you want to compare before and after, just press Y on your keyboard. Now we have the original master image here. And then all the images we're just working on here, removing the blue color cast, and as you can see, there's a big difference. Now we're going to set the highlights, which fine-tunes the lighter portion of the image. In this particular image, the men's earrings right here has specular highlights, which we're not going to measure. What we're going to do is we're going to adjust the whites and see the brightest area of the image where the clipping occurs by dragging the whites slider to reduce that. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to hold down the Alt key or the Option key on the Mac. We're going to click and drag this to the right till we see the first clippings. You see this series clippings here because we have Show Clipping on. Okay, that's quite important. That's why we did that. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to use the white balance selector tool. So click on that, then make sure you click on the one here on this field right here on the whites. Then move the color picker, whatever you want, where it has the clippings until you see the RGB, where it says 100%. So what you want to do is we want to back this off until we get to the 95%. Now, 95% is a magic number because it allows us to see the detail on the screen and basically will guarantee to have detail when we're going to print this. So we have, this way we have a pretty good idea that we made the image as light as we can without losing highlight detail. So what I'm going to do with this, I'm going to use my down arrow key here, okay, to back this off till we find this 95%, as I mentioned before, okay? And I'm looking at the RGB values here till we go to the 95%, like so, okay? So I'm going to press escape a couple of times, Now we're going to do the same thing on the blacks. So hold down the Alt key or the Option key on the Mac. Click and drag this until you find the first clipping. The first clipping is right here. So release that. Then you're going to use the White Balance Selector tool here again. And you're going to click on this field here. Now, reducing the blacks actually is quite subjective. And I'm saying this because sometimes we don't really care about details on the darks. So it's quite subjective if we want to do that. So in this case, let's go ahead and reduce this, okay? So again, we're going to use the White Balance Selector. Make sure that you have here, click on the field. Move the mouse right there which says RGB to the 0%. And now you're going to use the up arrow key till you go up to, let's say, 5%. 5% will pretty much do the same. This is going to bring some detail on the darks and at the same time be able to print some other detail. So you can press the escape a couple of times. And as you can see, we have detail both on the darks and on the whites. Taking this even further, we can create another virtual copy of that image and apply different adjustment settings. So I'm just going to hover over here on the film strip. I'm going to right-click and create a virtual copy and work on this copy. So what I want to do is if you look at the overall image here, it's a bit washed out, especially the man's face. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to up the contrast a bit. And as I do that, as you can see, I am losing a little bit of details in the darks, but it's not that bad, and I'm very okay with that, actually. But at the same time, you see I'm gaining some very nice contrast here. And another thing I can do is actually bring some of this sweater highlights here. You see, I can bring those more details back. So I'm going to bring down the highlights quite a bit, actually. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to press the Y key on my keyboard and compare those two. You see, this one is before, that looks a bit washed out, and this one is after. Man's face, it looks much better, and then also we have more detail on the sweater. What I recommend is to go through your images, see which ones might have a color cast, and look at the tonal distribution using the histogram. Do the color correction first, and then focus on the tones. Look at the loss of detail either on the brightest area or the darkest area on your image. And then finally, after all these corrections, then you can fine-tune your image with contrast and brightness. This concludes this lecture, and thank you for watching Third Element Turing Tutorials.